May is Motorcycle Safety Awareness Month. Now, as we all know, once the weather turns nicer, we see more and more bikes out on the road. And safety is crucial. So we checked in with a few of Cranston's finest and attorney Rob Levine to get the scoop on how to stay as safe as possible on the roadways.
When you take the motorcycle out for a run, safety should be a top concern. It starts with being aware of your surroundings and watching your speed.
When they first get on a motorcycle, your natural instinct is you want to go fast, and you're not as protected as you are in a vehicle. So speed is very important. Try to follow the safety speed limits as you know that are posted as best of your ability. We wear reflective cross straps when we ride, or a reflective jacket. We ride a black motorcycle. Sometimes during the day it gets dark, it's not as bright out. You want to be visible to the other operators on the road.
Riding together also has tremendous safety benefits.
If you can ride in pairs, it's also very helpful. I notice when we ride in pairs, you take up a bigger footprint in the roadway. You're more visible to the average driver than when I ride solo.
The roadways are full. You can never make assumptions when riding.
But don't assume that the normal operator sees you, because they don't. If you think they see you, assume they don't, because they never do.
You must have a valid motorcycle license to ride. It ensures that you possess the proper training and know the rules. Without one, you'll be in some trouble.
What happens is that you don't know how to react in an event of an emergency on the road, or in the event that your motorcycle does have a mechanical issue and forces you to make an emergency stop or an emergency maneuver so you do not hit someone else. The more that we can get the message out to motorcyclists and regular passengers about safety for motorcyclists, the better that the chances are that we don't have to investigate fatal motorcycle crashes.
A longtime rider, Rob Levine knows firsthand just how strong of a priority safety should be.
I understand the dangers of motorcycle riding, especially in our state. We don't have a helmet law for the driver, so it's an extreme risk. And it's not even really the motorcycle rider, it's most of the time it's the other car.
His goal is simple.
I'm there for people, obviously, if they need us, but I would much prefer to be out in the community, social awareness, prevent things from happening, and protect the public rather than have to deal with the aftermath.
Avoiding negligence is paramount.
The more educated drivers are, and the more educated motorcycle riders are, and the more they work together, we'll prevent accidents every day.
I couldn't agree more with the guys, so be safe out there and share the road respectfully. I actually know a thing or two about being around a bike. Before we parted ways, I let Rob know about it.
You know, Rob, I don't like to brag, but I've done a little bit of riding myself.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That should be interesting.
Yes, I love it. Well, the inspectors also told us how crucial it is to wear a helmet. Many of the injuries they see could have been prevented if the individual was wearing one. They also informed us that it is a law to wear eye protection at all times as well when riding. Some good reminders. For more information on motorcycle safety and attorney Rob Levine, right on over to roadshow.com.